Meet Kizzy, the sneaky one. Meet James, the good son.
This Hello.
Huh?
You
doing a vlog?
Yeah.
What is up, gang? You guys know who it is. I'm going to start off with just moisturizing my face because when I got out the shower, I was giving very much zombie crawl for this October. So I'm going to get that together. And I just wanted to pop in and welcome everybody to my first ever Living Alone series on this channel. I hope you guys enjoy it. It's going to be featuring my kids, both James and Kenzie. My oldest will not be in this video, but he will be in future videos. If you're new here, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. Do not forget to leave a like for the family. You are now a Rockefeller. Also, anybody who's just coming back to the channel, welcome back, guys. Let's get right into this video. Tempted to put y'all up in the cabinet because I don't got no good angles up in here. This place is like, I'm about to try, girl. I'm about to try. Pause, right? Because I'm gonna make a light breakfast because I want to eat some more spaghetti. I could just eat the spaghetti for dinner again tonight. It don't matter. But we are back. The energy is not all the way there yet. I did not have a monster today. Don't have any monster. So, it is 10:02 in the morning. And it is, because I don't keep up with my days like I'm supposed to. It's Wednesday, the 27th of September. So, let me make sure this thing. So, I just checked my camera. So, I'm going to adjust my clip. I think that's a cool spot for now. For me to talk to y'all while I cook and stuff, but real quick, I gotta throw something on my lips because they looking real bad, real bad. And I know y'all wasn't gonna tell me, because who the fuck does? Y'all never fucking tell me. And I guess that's just part of being nice. I thank you. Thank you guys so much. Okay, I'm gonna do the light lip today. Breathe. I'm just gonna take some brown lip liner. Then I'm gonna take my NYX, y'all. Excuse this fan in here because I can't turn on the good light without the fan coming on. So that's just why you hear that. NYX Professional Makeup Butter Gloss Lip Gloss Stick, and it is in the color Fortune Cookie. So that's what I'm going to be taking today on my lips. And just so I don't look too cray cray. Y'all lucky I did this much, because I could have had y'all being attacked by my goddamn edges or something. Yeah. This color on me is good even after the tan. I'm really, really tanned right now. The summer is still summering here. The sun is still doing its thing. Yeah, but let me get my butt in here and we about to start cooking. Y'all know I just love beautiful, pretty, shiny things. It's just part of who I am. And it's part of being a female. I think we all like that kind of stuff. I got that boombox, which is just a speaker system. It's a USB speaker. And I believe it plays the... No, it don't play the radio. So it's just a lot. It's a really, really, really nice speaker. This here is my waffle iron. It's a little dirty. I'm going to wipe it off because... it's got like a little stain on it. My son clearly used this and didn't clean it. He probably don't know how. And I'm going to show him how probably later on. I'm going to make chicken and waffles this weekend for dinner. And at that time, I'm going to show him how to clean it. Because this is extremely easy to clean. Yeah, after I cleaned it out and realized how easy it was to clean, I said I was going to show him. But I didn't show him yet. So, we're just going to make us a light breakfast, and I do want some waffles, so I'm one of those people who like to, like I was saying, somebody told me this like a few months ago. Now don't get me wrong, like I was not out of proportion. My stomach, because I had a BBL, so after I got the BBL, I'm not gonna say I had a slow healing process, but I probably should have got more massages or something, but I ended up gaining I tried to gain like 10 pounds to see if my butt would get bigger, because I was not exactly 100% happy with the results. I like the shape, but it just wasn't giving BBL. So I tried to gain a little bit of weight to see if my booty would get bigger. And I ended up gaining 30 pounds, y'all. I was not trying to gain that much weight. He said, I eat to live. I don't live to eat. And that made the most sense to me, y'all. Like, I have never heard of a saying when it came to health that made more sense than that. And I'm like, he's right. So when you feel like that, you don't eat and worry about balanced diets and this little system that the community put together. You don't worry about the systems and the 2,000 calorie deficit type thing. Now, it's good to know that, but if you eat a person that eats to live, let me go and start my food though. But if you think back to like the days where people would live off of just nothing but whatever they grew, they ate to live. They didn't live to eat. If you live to eat,
which is sounds so good, that sounds
man, you literally will indulge. You'll have enjoyed the things that we've all created for us to eat, and you'll take advantage of that. But you have to discipline yourself. You're literally just putting food in your body and making sure your body has something. It doesn't matter what the fuck it is at that point. Like, it don't matter if it's a healthy, balanced diet or not healthy. Just put something in you to survive. And also train your body to survive off of little. Don't try to eat a whole lot. You can train your body to get full off of much smaller quantities if you just eat smaller quantities on a consistent basis. And then your body will eventually, as your stomach shrinks down, it compresses just like a contraction, and it'll contract down just like your uterus does after you have a baby.
after time it contracts down after about a month or so, and then it gets smaller because you have not stretched it past that point. If your stomach is this big on the inside of your body, and I'm talking about the actual stomach muscle, it's being filled with food all the time, it's gonna stay that size or get bigger, you know. And then if you don't put food in it, and you only putting this amount of food in it all the time, and it's this size, it's going to start contracting down, because that other size, it's going to make you feel hungry, but you're not hungry. Your stomach is just, you know, wanting you to fill it up, and that's not realistic. You're not supposed to be filling your stomach up anyway. Like, you're supposed to eat till you're not hungry. You're not supposed to eat to get full. When you let it get down to that size, once your stomach contracts down to that size and you're still putting that same amount of food in your stomach, guess what? Your stomach is full and you're gonna feel full. So that's how that works. I'm not sure if I want to eat French toast or the waffles. I've been trying to figure that out for the last hour. Since I bought a waffle maker, I might as well use it. I don't got no open box. So what I use is the buttermilk pancake mix, and it doesn't really care matter what kind. For me, certain things, I don't care. Bisquick and Hungry Jack or whatever other ones that's got pancakes, that's name brand, I can't tell the damn difference between pancakes if they name brand or not. The powder, I can't tell the difference between rice. They all the same to me. Eggs, I'm not gonna go pick a certain brand of egg. I'm gonna go Quaker oatmeal. That's another thing, oatmeal. I can't tell the difference between who's oat, non-name brand oat and a name brand oat. Grits, that kind of stuff, I don't, y'all miss me with it. But I didn't want to open a new box if the other box was still in there. Just making sure. And I'm also going to make, I made a mess, y'all. I'm gonna try to straighten up my kitchen too while I cook. I just made a whole mess all over my arm, like it shot out. And now I look ashy, really. I want y'all to, I want to make some eggs, but the last time I made eggs, I don't know what they did to the eggs, y'all, but the eggs were egging. Eggs is one of my three favorite foods. I love hamburger meat, I love eggs, and chicken, of course, because, you know. But anybody that know me, they know I have to eat at least 4 eggs when I eat eggs. I love eggs. I eat eggs almost every day of my life. But I stopped eating eggs because the last time I made eggs, they were so gross and disgusting. Like, I don't know what they did. All I know is that the eggs got super expensive at the grocery store. They was like, they went up to from like under $1 to $7 or $8 for a pack. What do you call it? A carton of eggs? It was like that for months. So people stopped buying eggs. The eggs stopped even being in the stores for a minute. It was just only selling brown eggs. And I'm not sure where y'all live at, but I live in Ohio, and that's where this shit just happened. And then I went to the grocery store the other day, and I noticed the eggs was back down to $1.30 for a 12, for one full carton. And to me, I don't know if they went back down before, which I think they did, because I wouldn't have bought as many as I did. And them eggs don't taste right. They don't even egg. Like, you know how fluffy eggs taste? No. They taste like expired eggs or something. I don't know. It didn't taste. The texture was disgusting for me. That's what it was. It was the texture. The taste wasn't bad, but the texture was fucking horrible. Yeah. I'm gonna put the batter in here for my waffle because I like to have the corner where I can get it all out. This I'm gonna use for my eggs, scrambled with cheese, please. And I'm not gonna make 4 eggs for me because we're eating now to live. We're not living to eat anymore. So I meant to go back to that. So the guy told me, right, that this is what he's been doing. He used to be a big guy. He lost a lot of weight, right?
So I'm a runner. I have not ran in a very, very, very long time because I had my daughter, didn't have a body weight on me to get a BBL, but I always wanted a little butt, you know what I'm saying? Never had the body weight because I was always so fit. Got pregnant with my daughter. Husband said, hey, if you was really serious about that surgery, why don't you go, you know, you got the weight on you now, right after I had my daughter. So I decided not to lose the weight from having her and to go ahead and, I'm lying, I'm going to make 5 eggs, but my daughter going to eat quite a bit of these. She's just as bad with eggs as me, so, but I went ahead, I'm like, huh, you right, like I did have a weight. So I tried to hold on to that weight until I could have a surgery. And so that's what I did. Ass up in here. I need to be making sausage. I got a lot of sausage I need to cook. So, yeah, all of this is going to have to get cooked. I think the bacon will last longer than the sausage. So we're going to have to start getting rid of this. And sausage costs so much at the store, too, that I'm not caring about the name brands here. But this is one of the items I will usually get by Vevin sausage. Because sometimes sausage don't be tasting right. I'm going to make these. Because I feel like these last less longer than these do. So. But I'm just talking to y'all. We're not going to be showing y'all the actual cooking process. I'll have some cook with me vlogs or something where you can actually see what I'm doing and what I'm putting in it. And actually watch me cook it and watch it cook. But right now, that's not what we're doing. So I just threw a little bit of Kobe Jack cheese in there. But yeah, he basically told me to eat to live, don't live to eat. And ever since I followed that, let me tell y'all, when I went to Houston for my birthday, I was 201 pounds. I was 201 pounds. And I came back, I got back May 8th. He had told me that though, like right before I left. So I had went running there twice that week before. I didn't run again after that though, but I only ran a half a mile because I hadn't ran in years when you think about it. Like I had a daughter, was trying to keep the weight on me, had surgery, couldn't work out after surgery. So I had my surgery October, I believe it was 2021. Yeah, and so it's going on 2 years. Yeah, actually, like, just literally started eating what. Just put something in your body. Your body just wants something to feed it so it doesn't die, right? So when you blank your mindset and you go all the way off of the food thoughts, that means literally eat whatever you can get your hands on as if you were in survival mode, right? And sometimes when you do stuff like that, you're not gonna eat what you would normally eat. You don't have to be picky and choosy anymore. So when you want to put something in your body and you have the money to put the shit in your body, not like those people that have to literally do that and go find their own food and kill it and eat it, you know, when they were actually in real survivor mode, like we actually have the money to go out and buy things. So we purchase things that we're going to eat. And why not purchase something that might be a little bit healthy or non-fattening? So when we put something in our body, what I chose, well, I didn't choose it. He actually was doing this lifestyle already. So he would always bring me food. But what he would bring would be peaches or watermelon. Now, watermelon, not fattening at all. Peaches aren't either. Gotta watch your sugar intake. But definitely was all we ate. He would bring like a bag full of them though. And we would get full off of peaches. And the crazy part is, one peach would fill me up. One big badass peach he would bring would fill me up. We ate those quite a bit, probably like 3 or 4 times a week. Now, on the weekends, I would eat whatever I wanted. It didn't even matter. But most times, I would navigate towards chicken because I love chicken. Is easy, it's quick. You know, and you feel fulfilled after eating chicken. So that was one of the things that I noticed. I don't know why I didn't fry these fucking sausages, y'all. My dumb ass. Let's get some sausage patties up in here. But yeah, so we would eat pretty much just fruit all week, and that would be all that we would eat. Once a day, we ate fruit, got full off of it, and we didn't eat again. I did this with him for about a month. And by July, I had lost 30 pounds. September, I lost 40 pounds. So everybody keeps saying, it don't look like you had that much weight on you. Oh, but I did. I gained a little bit of it back, though, because see what I'm eating. You know what I'm saying? But I haven't been working out either. I only ran that 2 times. I never worked out again. But I'm about to get back on my workout kick because I've always been a fit person. But I was just trying to... I feel like I lost a little too much weight, so I wasn't wanting to be that small. I like this little case. Look at this little carrier for the sausages. They really, like... did they little thing. I like it. It's so easy to please you. What's up, Mom? What? They hard to get out of here, though. What? You're 4? Oh, you just learned that, huh? You're not 4 yet. You're 3.
No.
Uh-huh. You're a 3-bee. Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't you do that. Make me a sausage and egg sandwich, and then I'm going to get a waffle. That's what I'm going to do. You guys, this is one of the products that I sell on Amazon. This is a luxury egg container, and it has 2 rows, baby. This is my product from my brand. I do not have them at the store for sale yet. This is what's in half of those boxes over there. I have this gray color, and I also have it in a white. This is the gray. And I just love gray, as you guys can tell. Everything, my counters, everything is gray. So that's why I picked this one for me. But I do have 2 colors in this. And I also have other products that I sell as well. I'm going to go ahead and cook this food. I'm about to vibe out to some music. And I will be back in a minute. Get your little fingers out of there. They can never tell the difference between syrup. So since they can't tell the difference, I keep this for me. And they are okay. Oh shit. And they are okay with anything else. But since they can't tell the difference, just like I can't tell the difference between rice and oatmeal and all of that kind of stuff. And flour and sugar and brands and stuff. So I just buy whatever. So I buy this for them. And that way I can keep more of this and we don't run out of this as quickly as we run out of this stuff. Because this stuff only costs $2 and this stuff costs $8 or $9. So for that, that's why I do it. Just in case y'all gonna ask, because I know somebody in the comments gonna ask. And that's what it is. I'm about to go ahead and eat, and we about to get into this hair.
Cheers.
What's up to all my rocks out there? I'm back. So I ate my breakfast and I sat here for about an hour. And I just, it's 12:25 right now. And what I'm doing is I just got done watching a girl. Where is the dang old remote? I just got done watching Veda. I can't pronounce her last name. And they don't say it on her intro either. Okay, good job. I pull this up so I don't have to hear the TV. Her name was Veda. She got like 278,000 subscribers. She's not a new YouTuber, but her vlog was only 40 minutes long. That's what I'm talking about, okay? And then I'm seeing Arissa and Julie. I have not watched her yet. And I want to watch her later. So later on today, I'm going to peep her out. And I'm going to also peep out Gina B. So she looks fly. She's pretty, pretty brown. So we're going to check those two girls out. And I did find another girl. Was that last night or earlier? I'm sick. Maybe it was Veda that I found. That might be what I'm talking about. I don't know. I don't remember. But so that's what I'm about to do. I'm about to go ahead and get to this hair though, because I decided to go with the wig because I didn't look for the hair glue for my quick weave. And I don't feel like it. I'm being lazy still. But before I get into that, I want to soak my nose rings again because my nose be feeling itchy. And I feel like this is the only nose ring that does that to me. Ow. And then it makes my nose look a little funny around it. So I'm going to put this in some alcohol real quick, and then we're gonna get to the hair. Leave my nose ring sitting up here on this, and then I take 91% rubbing alcohol. So right now my nose ring is soaking in the alcohol. I'm gonna put a little bit more. Oh, look at it. Let me get my music on and we're gonna get started. I just keep walking away. I'm so full, but yeah, I'm about to go ahead and section off my hair, braid it up, and then we're gonna get to this wig install. What do you want?
Pull up.
I think about you all day, mommy. I know I'm a pit bull, but darling, mommy, I just wanna take you on a holiday, mommy. Say what's on your mind, I'ma call away, mommy. Come and rescue me. Whoa. Take me out the club, take me out the trap, take me off the market, take me off the map. I'm tryna hit the group chat and tell them it's a come and rescue me. Take me out the club, take me out the trap, take me off the market, take me off the map. I'm tryna hit the group chat and tell them it's all. I don't really know how to confess my love. Really seem like I wanna test my love for you. Don't know how to express my love. That's why American Express, yeah, 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 is my love for you. I need you, yeah, I really do. Tell me what to do. Tell me what to do. Tell me what to do. All I know is hit them all and see what damage I could do.
Okay.
I give you the world, but there's other planets too. And I need someone to be patient with me. Someone to get money with, not take it from me. But they don't even need to be as famous as me.
I don't think I'm going to be
but notice that my baby looked like Prince in his growing up years. He's giving Prince vibes. But I'm picking him up from school real quick, and I had to throw on a hat on my hair because it is not done. So I gotta hurry up and pull off because he's probably gonna be mad at me looking like I'm looking. So here he is. Hello. Huh?
You doing a vlog?
Yeah.
I'm trying to bust on, 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 bust on,
LA girls, let me see. see your hands. Wave them at them bitches, I know you with their friends. But you got it, let them know that everything big. Nails down it.
It helped not to be yourself around me. Yourself around me.
This is the finished results of the curly wig, and I like it a lot. It's very full. I love how full this wig is.
Yes.
Yes. Kenzie loves it.
Let's
she told me I was beautiful.
Snacks.
She said you were beautiful,
Let's
mommy.
Get some snacks,
you were supposed to take a bath. That was the deal. You take a bath.
No.
And if you take a bath, I'll get you a snack. If you don't, I'm not getting you a snack. This is the very first time in her life that she didn't want to take a bath, which is absolutely fucking insane to me because she loved baths. Like, she be begging for them.
Baths not fun.
And all of a sudden, she done watched one of those cartoons where one of them kids didn't want to take a bath, and now she acting like that kid. My daughter is very animated. So, that's what you're seeing. She sounds like a cartoon character because she's animated. But, yeah, so... this is very beautiful. I ended up cutting the front. I cut it so it's not too long. It's giving some kind of shape to my face because this hair was way too long for me. Like, I'm not... and I did it like this with some curl because I want to eventually wear this hair bone straight. And it's just... that would have took way too long to get it bone straight on this first run because it's a curly wig. But this looks really good. It's straight and great. And they say that the curly hair, most beauticians buy curly hair and straighten it because it actually looks better because it's fuller, it's thicker than if you buy straight hair. Straight hair is not as thick. But this actually looks thick. It looks full and it looks good full. Sometimes it looks like you have too much hair on your head. I don't think this looks like that at all. I think this looks like a perfectly healthy ass head of hair. That's what it looks like. I did cut my baby hairs, and I was worried that I was going to do this because I cut them shorter than I normally would ever do. And I did that on purpose, but I cut this too short, baby. And I kind of fucked this up. I ain't going to even hold you because it's so short. And then I didn't really swoop it well, so... it's like, once I put my hair up to go to bed, I'm going to swoop this better and put the band on it. But right now, I ain't going to worry about it. But yeah, it wasn't enough hair to like really do my swoop job that I wanted to do. And this hair wasn't even supposed to be there. Like, it just happened to be there when I took my scarf off. So that was fine. I ain't tripping. But so this is the final look for the hair. I should put on some makeup so y'all can see what I look like with makeup and my wig, but I think you can kind of get the picture of what I look like. So that's that. My vibes for today, I'm tired because I've been dancing all day and some good ass music, you know what I'm saying? But I feel this. I'm feeling her. I like it, and I think I did really good on my part too. I got some black spray that I can cover up my part with and make this more sleek. And I probably will do that. But I am ending this vlog right here because we done did a lot. We done had a lot of damn conversations. And now it's time for y'all to judge me. I don't care though because, y'all my friends though. Y'all not gonna do that. Y'all are Rockefellers. And Rockefellers don't judge me. They judge other people sometimes, but not all the time. Not a lot. We are a cult over here. We support each other over here no matter what it is. We're going to give support. We're going to do it. And we're going to do what we're going to do. Before I close out this vlog, though, I wanted to... girl, get out the water. You like my hair?
I like my hair.
Do you like my hair? Do you like it?
I like it.
Okay. Guess you could stay in the bathroom with me then. Be quiet though. I'm about to put on some lip stuff, some lip gloss or something, just to see how this looks on the end. And then I'm going to have a talk about basically in the future what I plan on doing with my channel. Because I want to do some things that's a little different than what the other YouTubers are doing. And because I want to actually feel like I'm talking to you guys. Like, I don't want y'all to have to comment on my stuff and support and y'all thinking like she don't know who I am. She will never know me. You know, I want to actually know my supporters and my subscribers because, come on, girl. Why is you doing bad stuff? Why? Messing with stuff, too. But, I'll be right back. I used to be a long hair girl. I did. And I look good with long hair. Don't get me wrong. But I don't fucking. I'm more like a shoulder length kind of girl now. Like blunt cut kind of girl. That's what I am. So the next few wigs that I get, hopefully, if somebody is watching, I need some sponsorships that could actually give me wigs. I'll do the shorter wigs. I'm cool. Y'all got shorter wigs that y'all want to give out. A lot of girls don't want the shorter wigs. Like, but if I get one with length, it has to be a 24 inch at minimum. Like, I don't like the 22 inch wigs, even though my 20s be looking long, but they be thin. So give me 24 inches at minimum like this. Only thing I really cut was the front, and we good to go. But what I want to do with my channel though, y'all, is I want to start going on a chat like every Friday night. But this is not going to be any time soon. I have to get like a lot of subscribers first though. Where on Friday nights, we're going to have where you guys can join a group chat. And it's going to be like a live group chat where we can see each other. Or at least you can see me and I can invite you guys one by one. Like kind of like Instagram where you FaceTiming each other and talking to each other. You can invite so many people on the call, and TikTok has it too. But like, I want to do something like that every Friday night where we have 2 hours of time for us. Now, but I want to do that because I want y'all to feel like y'all know me, and I'm not funny acting. We all people. I'm a normal person just like you guys are. I don't want this to just be like people subscribing to me, and I got a following, but I don't never know none of my people. And those one time a year meet and greets, of course I will do that, but I don't feel like that's giving the same energy as, you know, what I'm talking about, to be in a group chat on Friday nights for 2 hours. So everybody can come in. I will see y'all in the next vlog. Good night.